7 o'clock, so we will begin. I welcome you to this J.B. Lyle Parents Preview Concert, a.k.a. Jablyle Parents Concert. The kids are from naming it that. We'll talk a little bit about what is J.B. Lyle Festival. But before we begin, what you're going to see is five choirs tonight out of three different classes. We have up first our men. These are the men from our Matterwells choir, which is our advanced SATB choir. I would love to take credit for teaching them all this music. The truth is, I tend to program about two or three pieces more than I can actually teach during a day. And so the men, not wanting to be left out of the program, they really took it upon themselves to get in the practice room when we were working on some other things, and they have, by and large, taught themselves these notes, and hopefully I'm going to help shape it and do some music with it. But I cannot tell you how remarkable these young men are for having taken this task on and learned this stuff as well. I hope you're going to enjoy it. I also, before we begin, want to thank Mr. Tim Flanagan in the back. This concert is being live streamed on Facebook. The video guy is, I think, what you can type in on Facebook to find his stuff, or Tim Flanagan. Like his page. He records things all over the Tri-Cities, and especially for Bristol City Schools, a lot of our events. And so we thank him for doing that. So this way you can, you don't have to have your phone out. You can just put it on silent, keep it in your pocket, and enjoy. And then if you want a video of the concert, just head on down to the video guy on Facebook, and you'll be able to find it. He archives those. It'll be up for a long, long, long time. So thank you very much, Mr. Tim Flanagan. And without further ado, here we go with our Tennessee High School men's ensemble.
Thank you.
Okay, so we are almost done with November. It's not quite been 2 months we've been in school. So far, your students this semester we've taken 8 or 9 students to all-state screening auditions where they had to pass 7 or 8 songs. They had to sing, prove that they could sing them so they could make their way to all-state. So we have several all-state kids going. That was a big deal coming up. We were able to do a Valentine's fundraiser, singing Valentine's. I want to especially thank Ms. Kelly Sexton and Ms. Denise Tran. They donated all of our treats and flowers and helped settle that stuff up, which was really great because about half of our madrigal class was also participating in the musical Xanadu. So we've already rehearsed and produced a very large scale production. Many of these students were in it, and it was a great time. But we have been absolutely super slam busy. Slim Pickens has already performed once this semester. So we are very, very busy, and want you to congratulate your students, not only working up this music, but being involved in everything else they've been involved in. Has been, it's been a wear, it's been a lot of work for them, and I'm real proud of them, and we're not even halfway through the semester, so we got lots of good stuff coming up. Also coming up, what's not already passed, obviously, is the J.B. Lyle Festival concert, which is March 6th. You'll be getting a permission slip, hopefully, this week. I'm just waiting to get it back from our administrators, and then I'll send that home with your students, and that's all of these students that need to have that. They will need to have money for a fast food type lunch. We're going to eat lunch on the way down to Greenville High School at the Impact. And then I'm asking for them to do $5 for the bus to help offset our bus costs. We have a lot of expenses, and I try not to do too many fundraisers on you, so we're just try to offset some of the costs of some of these things. So that will be coming home shortly this week. As soon as we get back from spring break, the Madrigals and Advanced Blues Choir are going to be singing at the Virginia Dell Festival. That is March 28th. It's different maybe than what was on your calendar before because they moved around. Virginia Dell Festival, Virginia Dell was the former choir director of Tennessee High School. Former choir director. She's been too removed, I think. And so in her honor, we show all of the fine arts through the elementary and middle schools and high school students. There's an art show out in the lobby of Viking Hall. And then in Viking Hall will be all of our music students, all three of our bands, the elementary, middle, and high school bands. The middle school choir, our Madrigals and Advanced Women's Choir, and our elementary choir, directed by Ms. Valerie Picker, and then some other elementary classes will be doing some things. So it'll be a lot of fun to come and see all the variety that we have to offer in Bristol City Schools for the arts. And also it's kind of neat to see how your students progress. You may remember them singing in the Avoca Christmas program. And now they're up here on this stage doing a little bit different type of music. So make sure you want to come out for that. And we have some more things coming up. I'll let you know as things come. But we're real excited about the rest of our semester. So this is our Advanced Women's Ensemble, and they've got a set of songs for you. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
is by actually a composer that we know more for his marching band or his band music, Edward Elgar. And we feature violins, Mr. David and Jonathan Lugo. They're brothers. They have a very musically talented family on string instruments. They have,
what's the name of the quartet? Tensegrity.
You need to catch their quartet. It's phenomenal. So we thank David and Jonathan for being with us on this piece.
Thank you.
This is our, what we're calling, I'm not sure if I've settled on a name, this is our combined women from the bands, women's choir, and they're going to do a set of songs.
Thank you.
If you've never heard a solfege, give us that.
There you go.
Torrents out, and they're going to sing a few bars of it with the solfege. This is how we learned this song to begin with. I guess we should have probably sung an E flat scale. Why don't you use an E flat? We'll do the whole thing again. 1, 2, 3. By hearing it and regurgitating it. We want them to actually understand the music that they are attempting to sing. And sometimes do a little better job of it than others, but you know, that's the way it goes with everything, I suppose. So at the festival, we will sing, each of these choirs that you've heard will sing three songs, and then they will run off to another room where they get to sight read, and then we'll be given a score based on that. If we score well enough, we get to go do this again at the state level, and that's always the hope. So I want you to be thinking about your kids. We are working really, really hard. We are not letting mistakes go by, and we're not letting individuals go out. I know maybe in large choirs, church choirs, there's some people that are really singing, and then there's maybe some people that are kind of up there, with a joyful noise and a smile on their face. But in these ensembles, we're really demanding the kids know their parts and know what's happening and what's going on. And so while choir class is supposed to be the fun, easy class, and I do hope it's fun most of the time, it's also for them a little stressful because they're being demanded of. They are being asked to go beyond where they came in. So they've really risen to the challenge, and I hope you're enjoying what the music they're providing you, and they've worked really, really hard on it. To help us tonight, we have three adjudicators here tonight to give us critique so that the next seven rehearsals we can kind of clean this stuff up even more. And the first one is Carrie Carpenter. She's sitting right here. She is the accompanist and librarian at Volunteer High School, my old workplace. And we work together. In fact, I've known her for several years. She was my first student accompanist when I taught at Sullivan North High School, way back. Then we have Dr. Noah DeLong. He is the Director of Choral Activities at Milligan College. He's a great friend of our program, and he comes and hears your kids. So if you think, hey, I'd like to see my kids singing in a college choir one day, there's the man to talk to, and he will absolutely love to talk to you about all the wonderful things Milligan has to offer, and it is a wonderful school. My wife, Lee Whitson, who is also a music teacher. She teaches at Rock Springs Elementary, and she also directs the Colonial Heights United Methodist Choir in Hamville. So we give them a round of applause. Thank you for coming out. I will be sending home the times that we sing through the day at J. Lyle Festival. We start roughly 11:30-ish, and we end somewhere around 4:30, 4:45. And so if you'd like to come, please do. We'll be taking kids down on a bus, bringing them back to the high school. So you'll be getting a lot more information on that. Thank you very much, and we're gonna finish with these last couple of choirs. We have three songs left, and then I promise you can go. I'm going to visit. Usually I hang out on stage and visit with anybody that wants to visit. But I'm going to talk to our three people that came to kind of give us feedback tonight, so that anything that they want to just tell me, we can do that. And you three, we're going to go right out that door and into a quieter room, okay? And thank you so much for coming out. Thank you so much for sending your kids to school and ready to sing. This is a delightful bunch. There's not a bad apple in the whole group. They're all wonderful people, and they're doing wonderful things. So anytime you want to email me or stop by, I'm here at school every day, usually until around 4, 4:30. So please just holler at me if there's anything you want to talk about. Call me, text me, whatever you need to do. But I'm really enjoying your kids, and I hope you're enjoying the music they're making. So thank you very much. This is Madrigals, and this will be our last set of music.
You are Lord, you are Lord. Te temo, mi flor, te temo.